Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to look at a way to remember what the U.S. customary units are to measure liquid volume, also known as capacity. All right, with this method, it's something I call big G or super G. So what we're going to do is we're going to begin by drawing a big letter G, capital letter G. And this capital letter G stands for gallon. All right, inside the gallon, we're going to put some Q's, and we're going to put 4 Q's because a gallon is 4 quarts if we're doing a conversion. So we're going to place our 4 Q's in here. All right, and then when we look at a quart, quarts are made up of pints. A quart is actually made up of 2 pints. So we're going to put 2 P's inside each one of the Q's here, or each one of the quarts. All right, and then here I am working on the last one. And then we also have to add in cups. Each pint consists of 2 cups. So inside each pint, we're going to put 2 letter C's. All right, the kids really like this drawing because it's easy to draw, it's easy to remember, and most importantly, they're able to grasp the concept by connecting it to this picture. All right, and now let's work on some examples. All right, let's say that we had to do a conversion where we wanted to know if I have 1 gallon. And I wanted to figure out how many quarts that is. If you look at the picture, we see that the 1 gallon is comprised of 4 quarts. If we wanted to know how many pints were in a gallon, so 1 gallon is equal to blank pints. Well, we just count up our P's, 2, 4, 6, 8. So we see that 1 gallon is made up of 8 pints. And if we wanted to see how many cups were in a gallon, again, we just count 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. All right, if we wanted to look at this and say, all right, if we have 1 quart, and if I wanted to know how many pints made up a quart, again, I look at the quart, and I see that I have 2 pints on the inside of that. If I wanted to, again, work with quarts, and I wanted to know how many cups were in a single quart. Again, I could take any one of these Q's and just count up the number of C's. And you see here that we have just 4. And let's move on to another. Let's say we wanted to work on pints. If I had a single pint and I wanted to know how many cups, I look at the P and I see that I have 2 cups inside of each pint. All right, we take it a step further. Let's say we wanted to know what a half pint consists of if we were converting that to cups. Well, if I look at a pint and I take half of the cups that I see, half of 2 tells me that a half a pint would just be 1 cup. Let's go a little further with, let's go back to quarts. Let's say I wanted to work with half a quart and I wanted to know how many pints were in half of a quart. Well, if I look at the Q, if I look at half of the Q, I see that half of a quart is just going to be 1 pint. If I were to take that same question, half a quart, and wanted to know how many cups, well, if I'm looking at half, that's 1 pint, and we see that a pint is just 2 cups. All right, and a few more here. Let's go back to gallons. Let's say I wanted to know what, let's change the color here. Let's say I wanted to know what half a gallon was. Well, if I have half a gallon and I wanted to know how many quarts that was, well, if I took it, half of this gallon tells me I only have 2 quarts. If I wanted to convert that half a gallon into pints, well, if I take half of it, that would be these 2 quarts. And then these quarts, I see I have a total of 4 pints. And last but not least, if I wanted to see what that conversion was for cups, again, if I'm taking half, I just count the cups 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Alright, so here we quickly saw how to draw what I'm calling the big G or the super G. And with that, we can use that picture to do our conversions. Thank you for watching another video by ajspeller.com. And as always, have a great day.